because they empower your vestry, your leadership, to make wise and faithful decisions and the wise and faithful budget for the next year. And I have found that a pledge campaign is also a great opportunity to prayerfully reflect on what your church really means in your life, the difference it makes, and what you hope it will mean to others around you, people who have not yet shown up here yet, who have not seen yet the grace of God radiating from this place. Also want to be clear, asking nothing of you today. Rather, today starts a season, 5 weeks of prayer and discernment for you to figure out what pledge makes sense for you and for your household. In the next week or so, those of you who are on our mailing list will receive a pledge card in the mail. And I want you to do me a favor. When you get that pledge card in the mail, rather than, you know, letting it sit in your pile of to-do, and believe me, I have my, you know, philanthropies, I have pledge cards, and they get into that pile of things to do. I want you to just pull it out and put it somewhere in your house, somewhere you can see it, somewhere that's meaningful to you. A place where when you see it, instead of feeling anxious about, oh man, I gotta figure out what my pledge is gonna be, a place where instead you can start to feel a sense of peace about it. I feel good that I'm gonna be able to make this pledge. I feel at peace that my gifts will enable this church to continue and to expand its fantastic ministries. And then October 29th, last Sunday of the month, we're going to ask you to bring that pledge card back to church, and we're going to gather all of our pledge cards together, mine and Raph's included, and we're going to gather them together, pray over them, and that is going to be the end of the campaign. So folks, I've given you three reasons why we absolutely should not have started this campaign this Sunday. Let me give you three reasons why we should. First, last Sunday, for those of you who were here or online, we had our revisioning workshops, which were absolutely spectacular. I hope everyone who attended had a great time, feels re-energized by this place. And I know, actually, that you do, because more than one person came up to me, either during the online session, afterward, after the in-person session last Sunday, and used these words, "I feel like God is doing something new in this place." Right? That's something worth giving to, I think. And this is the time to start putting our gifts toward what we think God is doing. Reason number two is that thanks to the hard work of your wardens and vestry, we are in a position to give you an update on the financial situation of this church, and it's good news, actually. Not a lot of churches can say that these days. Give you an update on our financial situation, on further visioning data that we've collected, about the building and other things pertinent to the future ministry of this church. That's gonna be on October 22nd, so the Sunday before in-gathering Sunday. Make sure to stay around after church for that important update. That's all the business stuff. Now here's the fun part. The third reason why it was a good idea to launch this campaign today is because we are still reading Exodus. We are still journeying with the Israelites on this wonderful, weird, bizarre, beautiful journey from slavery into freedom. And so we are building on those same themes during this campaign. Up behind you, everyone, yeah, go ahead, take a look around. Sorry for the folks online, I don't know that we can swing a camera around, but you'll get a chance to see this at some point. You'll see a very amateurishly made ark. I can say amateurishly because I'm the one who made it. Half the job of being a pastor is kind of being a kindergarten teacher, I think. Ark of the Covenant, that's our symbol. That's our guiding light during this campaign season, because we will continue journeying with the Israelites who had the Ark before them, the Ark of the Covenant before them. And you will see over the next few weeks, as we get closer to ingathering, that Ark is gonna make its way up to the front of the church. Friends, the theme of this campaign, and really I think the theme for the next year in 2024 itself, is walking forward together. And we put a lot of thought into those three words, walking forward together. Walking, like walking out in the labyrinth, a key to the spirituality of this place. We are not stampeding in panic. We are continuing the practice of Jesus and the practice of the Israelites of just putting one foot in front of the other, continuing on with purpose, with steadiness, steadfastness, and with faithfulness in each step. And we are walking forward. We walk with a purpose. We are moving toward some place. The preliminary results from the visioning process have reaffirmed that you all want to build on the strengths you already have, building on the Family Ministries program, building on your beautiful music program and worship, becoming more and more a truly welcoming and inclusive place to all people and all kinds of people. You are moving forward, walking forward, and you can only do that, as I keep saying, together. It's going to take everyone to keep that journey going. You know, the Israelites did not swing back around to Egypt once they got to the Promised Land, right? So those, if anyone wanted to kind of stay in Egypt and wait and see if they actually were successful, they just got left behind. And that's the way it works, folks. Now is the time to join. Now is the time to be part of the journey forward together to that Promised Land, toward the presence of God, toward where God is calling this place to be. Because if everyone's not on board, if everyone is not part of that journey together, then we can't make it there together. I truly believe, as you have said, that God is doing something new here. I feel it. Folks, it's only been 3 weeks. I am already in love with you. Your mission of radiating God's grace, I feel it. I see it. Problem is, I see it in here. And one of the things I really want to work with you over this next year is stop making yourself the best kept secret in Deerfield and the North Shore. There is something here that people out there need. Somebody this week said to me, this place has a bushel basket over it. The nice thing about a bushel basket is you can just toss that thing off of you when you need to. So how can it be that you don't have just great family ministry programs, but you become known for having great family ministry programs. And you become known as a place where all kinds of families can bring their children and their spouses to church and feel safe and actually welcomed.
All right.
How can it be that you don't just have great music and wonderful warm worship, but you become known for those things? You become known for being a place of spiritual transformation. A place where people feel like their lives are changed, their lives are saved because they showed up at least once a week here. That's what I hope for you. That's the vision I see that you all are walking steadily toward. And that's why I'm asking you to prayerfully consider what you can give towards that work in the coming weeks. Before I sit down, I gotta talk about the Bible for a little bit. Surprise, surprise. Because here we are in Exodus, and we've got this great story. Again, remember, this is a journey not just of stages in geography. This is a journey of stages in growth and development, faith formation, we might say. And it's a development in the relationship between Israel and God. And Moses always getting caught in the middle, poor guy. We've been through the Red Sea. We could only cross it if we crossed it together. The Israelites have been hungry in the desert. God forgot to order lunch. Oops. And that was an opportunity for building trust, for learning how to listen to one another, and for learning that they could survive failure together. But as I said last week, things only get worse before they get better for them. Because this week they're not just hungry, they're thirsty, much more urgent. They say, we are dying of thirst. Our children are dying of thirst. Our livestock are dying of thirst. Moses is getting frustrated. What am I going to do with these people? As if to say, how dare they be thirsty? How dare they require water? But God, for once, doesn't seem so frustrated with them. Maybe that's growth on God's part. I want you to flip to the front covers of your bulletin, if you would, for a second. As always, we've got lovely cover art selected by Catherine. Because there's a spatial element to the story in Exodus. People say they're thirsty, God gives instructions, and the people and Moses listen. So God's instructions are this. He tells Moses, take some elders with you, take some witnesses with you, and go out ahead of the people. Don't take everyone, just take a few folks. You go out ahead of where you're going, and where you're going is Mount Horeb, also known as Mount Sinai, right? The place where God dwells, the place where they're going to receive the law. Go out ahead to that mountain, find the place of the rock where you're going to strike it, and from there, water will come out. The image here is that you strike the mountain that's over there, the water then flows back to where the people are. The water flows from the mountain that they're heading to back towards them. And so now, on this last leg of the journey to the mountain of God, the people are going to follow that water, that life-giving water, to the place where God lives, to the place where they will learn that freedom, that learning how to be free means learning how to do justice. Because the story comes down to this. You have to follow your thirst. That's that last leg of the journey with God. You have to realize that you're thirsty and then follow your thirst until you finally come to the place where God is. Why? Because the thirst that you have is the thirst that other people have too. The way that you're thirsty in your life is the way that your children are thirsty. It's the way that your neighbors are thirsty. It's the way that your coworkers are thirsty. It's the way that the other parents on Little League are thirsty. It's the place that your own animals are thirsty, for crying out loud. That thirst is what guides you. It leads you to the place that God has prepared for us to dwell in. That forward movement, that walking forward together, is propelled by that deepest thirst we have. And so my question for you is, what are you thirsty for, really? What do you thirst for, and what do you need in order not to be thirsty anymore? If we can do that, if we can name what our thirst is, and if we can find the waters that will sate not just our thirst, but the thirst of all those around us, then we can all drink from those waters, and the presence of God will be with us indeed. Amen.
Let us affirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, life from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge your baptism and forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
O God, our shepherd, you lead us into green pastures and beside still waters. Let our hearts overflow with gratitude for all the blessings of this life as we journey along right pathways for the sake of your name and in fellowship with one another. We invite those online to type your prayers of joy and gratitude into the chat, and they will be read aloud. The on-site congregation gives thanks today for Trevithick's Painted Stones, Scouts, Confirmants, Providence Farm Volunteers, Families of St. Cheese in the Pumpkin Patch, Beautiful Weather, Visiting Family, Father Dan, Vestry, Wardens, Baby Henrik, Male Shapers, Safe Trip to and from Michigan, Cool Breezes, and Many Helping Hands with Pumpkin Unloading, Altar Guild doing extra work for confirmation, instruction, Eucharist. The online congregation gives thanks today for
the change of seasons, for friends and family, for phenomenal sermons, for family, friends, and walking in the forest preserves, sunshine, and fall. We give silent thanks in our hearts. We shall not be in want.
For God answers us when we call. O God, our shepherd, you walk alongside us in the pains of life and spread a table of abundance in the face of adversity. Guard with your rod and your staff those who suffer today from illness, injury, violence, injustice, loneliness, and neglect. We invite those online to type your prayers for the sick, sorrowful, lonely, and afraid into the chat, and they will be read aloud. Today, we pray for those on our parish prayer list, including Stephanie Christad, family of Amalia, the family of Paul Bifico and Max Smith, Amalia, Rhonda Hicks, Ashley Johnson, Eric Anders, Lars Christad, Star and Julie. The on-site congregation offers prayers today for the Rubik family, Xiao Xing, Sally Dunphy, Molly, Karen, Grace, M.K., Sloan, Carrie, Jane, Howard, Alicia, Iris, Mary, Larry, Grant, Bill, Kate, Mark, Sally, Lynn, Tony, Anne, and Max and family. The online congregation offers prayers today for
Carolyn, Lori, Philip, Jim, Elizabeth Hamilton, Carrie, Sandy, Michael, Cassidy, Addison, Janice, Vilma, Brenda, Barbara Hoffman, Ed Hoffman, and Don Caldwell, Jimmy, people suffering from natural disasters and floods, Regine, Suzanne, Crystal, Noble, and those in war-torn areas. We offer silent intercession in our hearts. We shall not be in want.
For God answers us when we call.
O God, our shepherd, though we walk through a shadowy valley, you save us from the terror of death. Let your goodness and mercy follow those who grieve. Welcome those who now rest from their journey, that they may dwell in your heavenly home forever. We invite those online to type your prayers for the dead and the dying into the chat, and they will be read aloud. We pray for those on our parish prayer list, including Paul Pathico. The on-site congregation offers prayers today for Tom, Lenny, Deanna, Paul. The online congregation offers prayers today for
Carol, Rick, John, Skip, David, Herb, Bob, and Ken Wilson. We hold our beloved dead silently in our hearts. We shall not be in want.
O God, our shepherd, God of Moses and Miriam, God of Aaron and Joshua, hear the prayers of your people who cry out to you with joy and with sorrow, and bring us into that heavenly country where there is no law but the law of your perfect love, through the one who died and rose for us, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. God of all mercy. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
My friends, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
Peace, everybody.
Peace, everybody.
Peace, everyone.
Peace.
And good morning.
Peace, all.
Peace.
Peace, everybody.
I wonder why my Thanksgiving for Ron's successful operation wasn't read.
I don't know that they got it. It seems like several were skipped. I'm not sure.
I think it was because so many of us commented afterwards that she didn't scroll back.
She didn't see it.
Exactly,
Dad.
I'm late. Would all those who are celebrating birthdays, anniversaries, or traveling this week, please come forward. Birthdays, anniversaries, traveling. Whoa, where's everybody going? Goodness. Are you all traveling together? No, okay. May your Creator, who knit you in your mother's womb, continue to bless you abundantly in the name of our Father, the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit, Mother of us all. Amen. Friends, may the road rise up to meet you. May the wind be at your back. May the weather be clear and airlines be merciful. And wherever you go, whatever you do in this great big world of ours, take the light of Christ with you. In his name we pray. Amen. Happy travels. Happy birthday. And let us all walk in love as Christ loves us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. Thank you. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and good and joyful to give you thanks, all holy God, source of life and fountain of mercy. You have filled us and all creation with your blessing and have fed us with your constant love. You have redeemed us in Jesus Christ and knit us into one body. Through your Spirit, you replenish us and call us to fullness of life. Therefore, joining with angels and archangels and with the faithful of every generation, we lift our voices with all creation as we sing.
In the highest, on high.
Blessed are you, gracious God, creator of the universe and giver of life. You formed us in your own image and called us to dwell in your infinite love. You gave the world into our care, that we might be your faithful stewards and show forth your bountiful grace. But we fail to honor your image in one another and in ourselves. We would not see your goodness in the world around us, and so we violated your creation, abused one another, and rejected your love. Yet you never ceased to care for us and prepare the way of salvation for all people. Through Abraham and Sarah, you called us into covenant with you. You delivered us from slavery, sustained us in the wilderness, and raised up prophets to renew your promise of salvation. Then, in the fullness of time, you sent your eternal word, made mortal flesh in Jesus. Born into the human family and dwelling among us, he revealed your glory. Giving himself freely to death on the cross, he triumphed over evil, opening the way of freedom and life. On the night before he died for us, our Savior Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his friends and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." As supper was ending, Jesus took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Remembering his death and resurrection, we now present to you from your creation this bread and this wine. By your Holy Spirit, may they be for us the body and blood of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Grant that we who share these gifts may be filled with the Holy Spirit and live as Christ's body in the world. Bring us into the everlasting heritage of all your children, that with Gregory and your saints, past, present, and yet to come, we may praise your name forever. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, to you be honor, glory, and praise forever and ever. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, these are the gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you. You feed on them in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Thank you. Let us pray. God of abundance, you have fed us with the bread of life and cup of salvation.
You have united us with Christ and one another. And you have made us one with all your people in heaven and on earth. Now send us forth in the power of your Spirit, that we may proclaim your redeeming love to the world and continue forever with the risen life of Christ our Savior.
Amen. Please be seated for a few brief announcements.
Good morning. My name is Susan Hitchcent. I am one of your two wardens here at St. Gregory's, and welcome to everybody this morning. And Dan, have you met me? Did you say brief announcements? So I have a couple things that I want to share. First is your vestry met this last Monday, and I have some things to share from there. It was our first opportunity to welcome Dan to the vestry meeting, so lovely time together. This has been said before, but we appreciate everybody who participated in the visioning workshops, and approximately 60% of our households participated, so that was great. You'll notice the back two pages of your bulletin has all the information. We also had it in the newsletter, but be sure to take that with you today. I often recommend you just kind of pull off the last two sheets, and you'll notice the first of the last two sheets has that lovely paragraph and picture of Shelley as we prepare for her send-off. We're going to host a town hall. Dan talked about that, and we've received some questions last week that I wanted to respond to, and it was about our food pantry contributions. We've had this process where we do, in fact, match the contributions that people make. Sometimes people write checks, or sometimes they do it on the Venco donate button that goes through Venco. And we're still providing a match to your donations. We want to confirm that. Year-to-date through August, we've sent $9,100 to the Deerfield and Vernon Township pantries. Yeah. we do not plan to bring back the red bags. Those of you may recall, we used to bring them up here and fill them with canned goods and such, and paper goods. But the pantries, particularly since the pandemic, prefer cash so they can stock their shelves with the items that they run out of, and they know kind of what those are. So we're going to continue to just be collecting cash donations. You've heard Dan talk about the Walking Forward Together. Let's see. I want to talk about pumpkins. So yesterday we had an incredible crowd helping to very quickly unload the truck and to put the pumpkins out in a wonderful design that Shelley had with spray paint on the on the grass. And you'll notice as you go out that some of the kids decided to spell a three-letter word. You can go find it. It's kind of fun. It is meant to be kind of spooky. But we still need people to sign up to staff the pumpkin shifts. So today, from noon to 2, we're still looking for somebody. We filled up shifts Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Thursday, we need both 2 to 4 and 4 to 6. And Friday, we need noon to 2. Saturday, we need several shifts, 10 to 12, 2 to 4, 4 to 6. And then Sunday, 10 to noon, noon to 2, 4 to 6. So please check with Shelley if you are available during any of those slots, or go online and sign up. We're getting ready to send out another round of college care packages. So start writing your personalized notes for the students. The names are in the bulletin. If you'd like to donate money towards items purchased for the care packages, please do so via the website or a check with a note in the memo section. For Shelley, we are going to be collecting for a purse, and so if you'd like to donate a gift to her, please do so via the website or check with a memo, and that'll be 2 weeks, October 15th. It's going to come upon us really quickly. Let me just see if I missed anything. There's a QR code about the pumpkin patch, not just for help, but there's also all kinds of fun things going on Fridays. We've got wonderful music, another spooktacular. I don't know if Vicky is a part of that, but certainly some of our other vocalists are a part of it, and it's wonderful music. And if there's your first Sunday with us, and I've seen a couple faces I don't know as well, please join us again. And if you feel inclined, fill out a welcome card in the back of the pew and give it to a greeter when you exit so we can keep in touch. I think that's all. Thank you.
Please stand for God's blessing. Friends, life is short, and we do not have much time to gladden the hearts of those who make the journey with us. So be swift to love and make haste to be kind. And the blessing of the God who made us, who loves us, and who travels with us, be with you now and forever.
Amen.
Go forth into the world rejoicing in the power of the Spirit.